Alrighty, we have Must Go, an antique 60s television storage space in Hattiesburg. Reduced from $100 to $30, Brian. It's a mid-60s 1985 Magnavox.
Really?
Yes. And this is, let's see, this is a beautiful television frame that held a television. Well, imagine that. My innovative mom smashed the screen, and I placed my grandmother's record player inside of it.
Well, if it must go, then put it out on the street. I'm sure somebody will pick it up, maybe.
I have also held books and all kinds of things, like my mom's ashes after she was killed by the imploding tube. It's a fun and funky storage space that makes one feel retro. What a fun buy. Oh, yes.
Oh, fun buy.
Yeah, fun.
Be fun for her.
Did they legalize marijuana in Hattiesburg? Is that what happened?
I don't think so, but I think there's plenty of people there that smoke it.
Obviously.
Yep.
The skies are looking ominous. Well, I'm a little under the weather still. I'm not going to work on the house today. So we're just hanging around, resting. Much needed rest. And I've been looking at this TV here, sitting outside under the carport here, since February. This was something I bought for a project with the film studios and wound up never using. And of course, it's gotten dirty out here. I paid $10 for it. Oh, is it dirty? This is a General Electric commercial skip. It's an RCA set. It's a CTC 185. And this was kind of a budget set. As we can see, it doesn't have anything with the RF connector in the back. Model number 25GT240, CTC 185 AA4. Manufactured July of 2000. Assembled in Juarez. So anyhow, it's been sitting out here for some time, and I figured, well, I mean, it wasn't in, I was actually just going to use the CRT and the chassis in this project, so I wasn't too worried about the case. I mean, the case will clean up a little better than this, but it had some paint splatters on it anyhow, and you know, it wasn't too hot looking, but it was running in the thrift store when I bought it, and it had an okay picture. And I think the CRT might have been a little soft in this one, but let's get an extension cord and run it over here and see what's going on. If you still have any Radio Shacks operating in your area, this 9-foot extension cord is on clearance right now for $3-something, and it's 14 gauge. It's just a single outlet, but for $3-something, you know, it's not a bad price. I figured I might have to use this somewhere in the new house, but we're going to use it today to 9-foot. Yeah, we'll see if, yeah, we'll be able to make it over here. Alright. Alright, so let's turn her on and see what happens. Unlocked. Put a signal to it and see what happens. Find the RF modulator. All right, we've got a signal to it with a test pattern, and you know, it's lined up pretty good. The could be a little sharper. Let's see if we can get into a menu here. Screen. The contrast too high. Let's sharpen it up a bit. Color tint. Black level. Just sharpen this up some. Well, you know, it's a little washed out. Well, that's looking a little better. This is still a very usable TV. I think the tube's still a little soft, but I mean, the picture is not bad. It really isn't bad. I mean, I wouldn't have any qualms selling this to someone, you know, for a modest price, if anyone was still buying these things. Let's open her up and have a look inside. I don't think I ever opened this one up. And the tank warns us this is a hot chassis. But here's a parts list sticker in here. CTC 185. Special characteristics important to safety. Blah, 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 blah. Printed in USA. All of our warning stickers and year. Oh, we got EIA 553. So this thing was built. In the 29th week of 2000 on the 4th day. So we'll figure that out if we care to. Tube type EIA 553 RCA. And we can see she's pretty dirty on the inside. Got some cobwebs in here, probably from sitting outside for all this time. But not a whole lot to her. Not a whole lot to her. Yep, got one speaker on this side. The other side, I guess if you had a stereo model, it would have had a speaker over here. What'd you have? So a quick look at this, which will be going in storage for anything in the future I can use it for. But a 2000 General Electric RCA built CTC 185 base model. Alright, have a good one, y'all.